Welcome to evening prayer. Let's pray. Great and merciful God, we come before you in love and humility. You are a God who is creator, and everything we know, everything we see, everything we are was brought into being by your word. You are a God who is love. You are a God who gives love. You are a God who loves us so much that you're prepared to stretch out your arms and die for us on a cross. You are a God who is peace, who brings peace to the world, and in whom all things are reconciled. You are a God in whom we become the body of Christ. You are a God who is worthy of our worship, and we long to bring our worship and our praise before you. But we come aware of who we are too, of the mistakes we've made, of the struggle of loving like Jesus, of hurting one another by accident and deliberately. We come knowing that we are not the people you would have us be, and so we ask you to forgive us for the times when we neglect you, for the times when we put ourselves before you, for the times that we damage other people with our thoughts and our actions. Creator God, God of love, God of peace, we come and ask for your forgiveness, and we hear your words of grace to each of us as you tell us, my child, your sins are forgiven. And we are grateful that in and through your love and the sacrifice that Jesus has made, we are forgiven and reconciled with you and with each other. And that through that we find the peace of your promise. So we thank you that you hear our prayers, that you care for us and watch over us. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Reading from 1 Samuel chapter 1, beginning at verse 4. On the day when Elkanah sacrificed, he would give portions to his wife Peninnah and to all her sons and daughters. But to Hannah he gave a double portion, because he loved her, though the Lord had closed her womb. A rival used to provoke her severely to irritate her, because the Lord had closed her womb. So it went on year by year. As often as she went up to the house of the Lord, she used to provoke her. Therefore Hannah wept and would not eat. Her husband Elkanah said to her, "Hannah, why do you weep? Why do you not eat? Why is your heart sad? Am I not more to you than 10 sons?" After they had eaten and drunk at Shiloh, Hannah rose and presented herself before the Lord. Now Eli the priest was sitting on the seat beside the doorpost of the temple of the Lord. She was deeply distressed and prayed to the Lord and wept bitterly. She made this vow, "O Lord of hosts, if only you will look on the misery of your servant and remember me, and not forget your servant, but will give to your servant a male child, then I will set him before you as a Nazarite until the day of his death. He shall drink neither wine nor intoxicants, and no razor shall touch his head." as she continued praying before the Lord. Eli observed her mouth. Hannah was praying silently, and only her lips moved, but her voice was not heard. Therefore Eli thought she was drunk. So Eli said to her, "How long will you make a drunken spectacle of yourself? Put away your wine." But Hannah answered, "No, my Lord, I am a woman deeply troubled. I have drunk neither wine nor strong drink, but I have been pouring out my soul before the Lord. Do not regard your servant as a worthless woman, for I have been speaking out of my great anxiety and vexation all this time." Then Eli answered, "Go in peace. The God of Israel grant the petition you have made to him." And she said, "Let your servant find favour in your sight." Then the woman went to her quarters, ate and drank with her husband, and her countenance was sad no longer. They rose early in the morning and worshipped before the Lord, and then they went back to their house at Ramah. Elkanah knew his wife Hannah, and the Lord remembered her. In due time Hannah conceived and bore a son. She named him Samuel, for she said, "I have asked him of the Lord." Within that passage we see a great care from Elkanah to his wife. Hannah has been the subject of ridicule because of her barrenness. She comes praying that God will show his care by granting her her dearest wish. Hannah receives the generosity of care from Elkanah as he watches over her, gives her a double portion. Hannah's care is shown in her trust in God and a prayer of confidence that God listens to. And God's care for Hannah is shown in the answering of that prayer. But wider than that, as we hand ourselves over to God, God's care for us is seen in all that he is prepared to offer for us. Jesus walking with the disciples, preparing them for the journey ahead, shows his care. And for each of us, that care is expressed in love poured out on a cross and beyond. So we ponder on God's care for us, perhaps especially today as we have been part of services of remembrance, and ponder on the care then that we offer to others.
Because he's given Jesus Christ. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son.
We offer you prayer, Lord, for the world, for leaders of nations and those in authority. And we pray that all may come to live in peace and mutual trust, that we might learn to share with justice the resources of the earth. We pray that your love would guide each and every heart. We pray for your church, every community of faith that goes about promoting your love and acceptance. We pray that we may mirror your love and grace by our lives and your teaching. We pray for those who are going through times of sorrow, those who are ill, those who feel discouraged and alone. We ask for your patience and a firm trust in your goodness. We ask for your healing touch, for your peace and grace, that lives may be changed and that each would know your loving presence at work. We offer you ourselves, our needs and concerns, and we give you thanks for the answers and resolutions already on their way. So we give you thanks that you hear and respond to our prayers as we offer them before you. In the name of Jesus, who taught us when we pray to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen. So, holy God, give us the wisdom to perceive you, the mind to understand you. Earnestness in seeking you. Patience in waiting for you. Eyes that see you around us and in us. And a heart that meditates on you. And may we proclaim you and your love through our love and care. So fill us and equip us in the power of your Spirit. Amen. So may the God of peace enable us to do his will in every kind of goodness and work in us what pleases him, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.